Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at some of the new announcements that came out of today's Worldwide Developer Conference keynote event. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So this morning started the first virtual Worldwide Developer Conference. The keynote event this morning told us all about the new operating systems that are coming. So we heard all about the new features of the iPhone, the iPad, the Mac, and other devices that we'll be getting later this year. So let's start with the iPhone and iOS 14. The home screens get a whole revamp now. In addition to being able to view them as you do now, you'll also be able to view the apps by category and do a search on them, including a full alphabetical list of all your apps. So even if you can't remember where you put an app icon, there'll be a way to get to it. Also, widgets aren't just going to be locked to the Today view now. You'll be able to actually put them in with your app icons on home screens. There's some updates to Siri where it won't take over the entire screen every time you use it. And also, dictation is going to take place on the iPhone itself. It won't be sending it out to a server and then coming back to you. So it'll probably be faster and hopefully more accurate. There's going to be a new app called Translate, which will allow you to translate between 11 different languages. And the idea is that it's not just going to look at each word and translate it, but will try to actually translate the meaning of the phrase or sentence that you're speaking. In Messages, there are going to be new group features and the ability to reply to somebody in line. In other words, you don't have to throw your reply at the very end of the list. You can reply to the exact message that you're referring to. The Maps app is going to get cycling directions, finally, and also newer iPhones will get the ability to unlock cars that support the car key feature. So instead of carrying around a separate little key for your car, you can use your iPhone for that now. And a cool thing you can do with that is you can actually send somebody access to your car so they can open the car up using their iPhone. Another new feature will be App Clips. This is kind of like a little mini app. You don't have to get the actual full app for a store or restaurant or something. You can use an app clip to quickly access a function or payment or something at a specific location or with a specific item. So some of that's coming to iPadOS as well, and of course iPadOS has its own features. It's definitely getting even closer to macOS now. A lot of apps now are going to have sidebars and toolbars so they look even more like the Mac apps. Here you can see the Photos app, the Files app, and the Music app all have these sidebars. The search feature is being updated and it really just looks like Spotlight now. It allows you to search for things across various different apps like files, websites, even launch apps from it. And a big new feature will be for Apple Pencil, the ability to translate handwriting into text. So you can just write in an input field with your Apple Pencil and it'll translate it to text. Or while you're taking notes, it'll keep it as handwriting, but you could actually copy and paste it as text into another app. And there are a lot of new features for some of the other devices as well. For instance, with AirPods Pro, you're going to be able to listen to spatial audio. So you're going to be able to hear sound from behind you somehow while, say, watching movies with surround sound. The Apple Watch is going to get sleep tracking, so you can wear it while you're sleeping. It'll track your movements. It'll even try to detect your breathing patterns and record all of that. Apple TV is going to get picture-in-picture and multi-user support, which is very important for games. Okay, so on to macOS. So, of course, one of the big questions everybody has is, what's the name of the new macOS? We went from Mojave to Catalina, and now the next one is going to be called macOS Big Sur. It looks like there are going to be some pretty big design changes here. Things actually look like they're moving closer to iPadOS. So iPadOS and macOS seem to be getting closer, at least in design. The corners are definitely more rounded. If you look at the dock actually floats up above the bottom of the screen. It's not attached to the bottom. Toolbars definitely look a lot more like on the iPad. And a big new feature is going to be Control Center. It looks like Control Center on the iPad. And Control Center and the menu bar icons at the top right part of a Mac screen are very similar, and it looks like basically Control Center allows you to combine a lot of those menu bar icons into the single interface. You can even drag and drop from the menu bar icons on the right into or out of Control Center. The Messages and Maps app are getting updates. They're actually going to be made with Catalyst now, so it's the same app on the iPad as it is on the Mac. So that means we're going to get features on the Mac like Memoji on Messages and Look Around or Street View in Maps. A big new update to Safari is going to be support for universal APIs for building extensions. So developers who create extensions, say on Chrome, can also easily have those available on Safari. And there'll be a whole new extensions gallery in the Mac App Store. So expect to see a lot more extensions for Safari once Big Sur launches. And another feature will be customizing the start page in Safari, choosing what features you want there and even setting a background. So perhaps the biggest news, and one that's not completely uninspected, is Apple is going to be transitioning Macs away from Intel processors to their own ARM processors. So first, developers of course are going to be encouraged to update their apps. And it looks like Apple's made this pretty easy. Most apps that have been well maintained should be able to quickly convert and create a universal app. So one app would run on both an Intel Mac and an ARM Mac. As a matter of fact, Apple already showed off Microsoft and Adobe apps that are doing this. The next part is going to be emulation. So this is when you take an older app that hasn't been updated yet and you want to run it on a new Mac that is an ARM processor. So Apple's doing it a little differently than how they did it from the PowerPC to Intel chips. This time, when you install an Intel app on an ARM Mac, you're going to get a conversion of the app to the ARM processor. So every time you run the app, you're actually running an ARM app. This should make things a little smoother. They showed off some apps running under this too, including a 3D game, and it looked like it ran pretty well. So you should be able to get an ARM Mac and continue to use your existing apps just fine, even if the developer hasn't updated them yet. Now, as far as virtualization is concerned, Apple mentioned emulating Linux, but specifically did not mention emulating Windows. So we could pretty much assume that it won't be easy to emulate Windows on one of these new Macs. But on the other hand, it will be easy to run iPhone and iPad apps. As a matter of fact, Apple is planning on having that as a core part of this. So you'll be able to install iPhone and iPad apps and run them in a window on one of these new ARM Macs. This greatly expands the number of apps that will be available on the Mac, especially games. So developers will be able to get started on this soon. They're having a quick start program where they'll ship a developer a special Mac Mini that has an ARM processor in it. And then they say the first Mac with these new processors will be available by the end of the year. No word on which Mac model that will be. And then over the next 2 years, we'll transition the whole line to these new processors. But in the meantime, there will be new Macs that have Intel processors, including some that'll come out later this year. So Apple says they plan to support both Intel and ARM Macs for years to come. So this is really exciting news, especially on the Mac side, as we're going to get a lot of cool stuff in Big Sur and a really bright future using Apple chips instead of Intel chips, which should mean more frequent and also more powerful updates for Macs in the future. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.